Hi, the internet. Welcome to the What Else Show. I'm your host, Robert. This is Bethany.
Hi, internet.
Today we've got another What Else movie review for you. And Bethany, what movie review are we reviewing today?
The movie review that we're reviewing today is Midway.
Midway. Starring, I don't know.
A bunch of people. Woody Harrelson.
Woody's in it.
Luke Evans is in it.
Bunch of famous people.
A bunch of famous people are in it. And also a bunch of people that we've never seen before.
True.
So there's a mix.
A little tease, a little synopsis of what's gonna happen.
This will be a spoiler-free review.
Yes, it is.
So no spoilers. Although if you didn't know that there was a battle at Midway, spoiler, there was a big battle at Midway. So basically the movie takes us from right before the attack on Pearl Harbor.
World War II we're talking about.
World War II.
Not the other time Pearl Harbor was attacked.
World War II.
Yes.
World War II. So 1941. And so it's taking us from that point in time right before the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Nope. We get to see the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Yeah, but the movie starts right before the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Yep. She's right. What do you want from me? Bethany's right sometimes. You know, sometimes I'm wrong.
Once in a while, I'm right about stuff. So it starts right before the attack on Pearl Harbor, mm-hmm. and it takes us all the way through and after the Battle of Midway. So there's quite a bit of a span of time that the movie covers.
Yeah.
So, it's about all of that stuff.
And what that happens. What are your impressions? Let me give you my quick impression.
It's long.
It's like 2.5 hours long. It feels every second of it.
It does. This movie is long. And it is plagued by some of the same problems that I see plague other movies about World War II battles, and that is there has to be so much context.
There doesn't have to be.
Okay, so there is context that they try to set at the beginning of the movie or throughout the movie, either like leading up to the battle or because of the battle or why the battles even occurred. And so then you end up with this super, super long movie with a lot of
exposition.
Yeah, and a lot of like narrative and a lot of explanation leading into the battle. And in this movie, it would have been better served to start us after Pearl Harbor had already been attacked, because I think that would have cut out at least like, I don't know, like the first half hour of the movie.
Let me share this with you. Mm-hmm. All right. This movie doesn't think people respect history and spoon feeds you everything the movie thinks you need to know.
Yes, that's an excellent
movie
point.
This movie thinks you're dumb, whereas Avengers Endgame assumes you know everything that's going
on.
And it respects the viewer as an intelligent human being who knows their history.
Yes.
Weird. That's,
that is so true, because they do spoon feed you all of this history about what happened at Pearl Harbor and that battle, and they were really trying to. I understand their intent. So the intent behind all of that content and exposition leading up to the Battle of Pearl Harbor was to prove that it was a military intelligence disaster, and so that's all that they were trying to do. But they could have accomplished that in a much more concise, simple way, as opposed to giving us kind of this really long preamble leading up to the Pearl Harbor
this
attack.
Movie has a lot of problems.
It does.
There's so many characters. I feel the movie lacks focus. It's named after one battle, and the movie still lacks focus. I know who the main character is, but there's so many other characters. I lose track. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know if they're going to be back. Were they actually
really important to the story? And some characters they introduce and we never see them again.
Yeah.
Through like the whole rest of the movie. And like, what was the point of that?
Just cut them out.
And so it's hard to get emotionally invested in what happens to the characters, because there are so many of them. You're like, I don't even know who to root for now.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even know who.
Bethany was rooting for the Japanese.
I'm supposed to be.
How dare she?
On. because it was kind of all over the place. So that really was a problem. And I will say there is another movie called Midway that was made, I think, like back in 1976. And that one I've seen, and it's good, but it is a World War II movie and also suffers from being too long. And this is not like a remake of that movie. It's very similar, has all the same similar characters.
Probably a similar story.
Very, very similar story. So I wouldn't really say that this is like a remake, but it also did not give us anything new. Like we're not given a new angle.
I didn't even get to the point in this movie where everything is so cliche that happens in the movie.
Very cliche.
You got your hotshot pilots that don't follow the rules. You got
cliche after cliche.
Your stern generals.
We know where this is going. Yeah. Yeah.
You got your guys that don't respect each other at first, but now they respect each other.
They're best friends. And yeah.
Yeah. So cliche.
Very, very cliche. And I felt like that really did a huge disservice to the movie itself and also the actors. You had some huge, big name actors in this. Give them something more to do than just playing out these cliche storylines. Give us a new angle on this battle.
Yeah.
I am fascinated by World War II history. Give me something new. Give me a different take. You know, I was really hoping for a different take. That's what I was hoping for. And I was thrilled that Woody Harrelson was in this movie. I absolutely love Woody Harrelson. But they didn't give him enough
really
to do. Yeah, they didn't give him enough to do. So
the only really good thing about this movie is like it's got like real fun aerial battles and real fun sea battles.
Yes,
and all the special effects look good.
Breathtaking views.
There are just some weird green screen shots. Moments in there that look awful, but for the most part, like all the battles look pretty cool.
Yeah, like the dog fights in the air. A lot of those looked fantastic. It just looked fantastic. And, with the technology and CGI capabilities that we have now, it's definitely better than, a lot of these older movies. But it's not... but again, it's like that doesn't make a movie.
Pull the emotional heartstrings like... a movie previously.
Yeah, it can't save this movie.
Yeah.
It can't, really can't save this
movie. You've badmouthed this movie enough, Bethany.
You prove
that you're not a true patriot.
I feel awful bad-mouthing this movie.
So give me your communist score of this movie.
Oh my God.
Hey, I call it like I see it.
I'm going to get so much hate mail after this. But you have to understand that I have been watching World War II movies from a very, very young age.
We get it. You hate America. What do you give this movie? Rate it.
I'm going to give this movie a 2 out of 5 without a recommendation because it's too long and they could have done a much better job telling the story and giving us a new take on the story.
That's a low score.
I know.
I think I'm actually going to go a little higher than you, and I think I'm going to go 3 out of 5 with no recommendation. Mm-hmm. The aerial battles and the sea battles are fun. I never really felt bored in the movie, even though it's super long. I'm gonna go 3, just a slightly higher than yours. Still not a recommendation. I don't really want you to waste your time
because it's a lot of time
it is
to spend. Yeah.
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 All right. I think that's all we need to know.
That's it. Yeah. I think that's it.
All right. So you can follow the show on Twitter at What Else Show. Send the show an email at thewhatelseshow@gmail.com or follow us on Instagram at mm-hmm. thewhatelseshow. Also, like, share, and subscribe to our videos on YouTube.
Yes.
Bye, Internet.
Bye, Internet.